one of the true rock stars of the resources world, a geotech.
Hi, I'm looking for Steve.
You must be Brian.
Yeah, you're the geotech, right?
Why don't we go down to my office and we can talk down there? I'm a well site geologist and I'm presently working for Encana as a geotechnician. A geotechnician would probably be more or less doing direct assessment of drill cuttings or cores, the small pieces of rock that come up through the wellbore as we're actively drilling, doing a core analysis, taking porosity, permeability, fluid saturations, you know, washing the samples, getting the samples back here for analysis. Put this all together, it is presented in what you call a strip log, which is a graphic representation of all the parameters, all the engineering data, et cetera. A typical day is usually up by 4:35, depending on what the anticipated workload is. I get my morning report in, which consists of the strip log and any other information that might be pertinent to the day's operation. And usually I retire between 10 and 11 at night, at it again at 5 o'clock in the morning, doing it all over again. Well, typically on these here, I work anywhere between 10 days and 2 weeks. In between wells, when you do have time off, you have some good time off. You pack your gear, you go home for a week or so, and then you come back and do it all over again. That's a good payoff there. I went to SAIT, Southern Alberta Institute of Technology. It's like BCIT. I would advise anyone to get a tech degree in the geotechnical areas. I suppose different tech colleges have different programs of varying lengths, varying curricula. I think one of the most important things is the experience. When I was mudlogging, I was volunteering to do the samples for the geologists, so even before I came out into the field, I had a good idea what was under the ground. I haven't looked back since then. I just keep on going. I got about 160 wells under my belt now in my career.
Steve, I brought you that sample. I've got a few here. I got five of them.
Oh, thank you very much. These are the meters that they come from, the 90.
Okay, so each depth has a different meter.
Yeah, these are 10-meter bags, say from here, from 2160 to 2170.
That's 2160 meters under the earth.
Under the earth.
That's what it looks like. What do we do with these now? I mean, you're going to
I'm just going to wash them up and get them prepared for viewing under my microscope and just give it three prints here.
So now we're taking these that have already been washed.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to put them on that, and that's a drying rack.
And we just wait till they dry. It might take about 5 to 10 minutes, depending. So then what I do, I take these samples, I put them in my examination tray. I'll view these samples under the microscope of this. I move the rock around with these little tweezers here, and when it's under magnification, you can see it quite nicely. So you have to have enough finger dexterity if you can pick up a little piece of rock like that. Translating the information that I see from here through my microscope to what I see on the PASON screen, the EDR electronic drilling recorder, to what I put in here requires a good amount of attention to detail.
What advice would you pass on to someone considering a career in this field?
Try and find a mentor. Try and find someone who's in the oil patch that you can talk to. You gotta have that good can-do attitude. If you're a young guy or gal who wants to, you know, get out there and get a career, I would suggest that you look into something like this. From a compensation standpoint, it's really good compensation. There's a wealth of information on the internet about geology. If you're willing to seek it out, it's there. You can find it. You can learn. I think having the willingness to do that is important, and this job has given me a good opportunity to learn.
Well, Steve, thank you very much for your time.
Well, I hope this helps some kids out who might be looking for a different career path to go on.
Once again, I'm Brian for CareerTrek, reminding you that this career could be yours. See you next time.